There are now more than 5 million confirmed cases of COVID-19 around the world. More than 1.5 million of them are in the U.S., the number one country for COVID-19. Russia is now in second place with just over 308,000 cases. And Brazil is in third with more than 270,000 confirmed cases. Its daily death toll keeps rising, too. The country's health system is teetering on the brink of collapse. Brazil's president, though, is dismissing concerns. And as Eric Sorensen explains, he's advocating the use of hydroxychloroquine, the same drug President Trump says he is taking.
Brazil is rapidly becoming ground zero for the coronavirus. Outlying areas don't have intensive care beds. Some patients are being airlifted. Hospitals are reportedly on the brink of being overwhelmed. And yet, on Sunday, Brazil's President Bolsonaro posed with crowds that were crammed together. The government has supported treatment, said Bolsonaro. We hope soon we'll be free of the issue. Congratulations to us all. But Brazil has seen its highest COVID-19 numbers just this week.
In daily confirmed cases, Brazil is over 17,000, right behind the United States at close to 20,000. Russia is reporting 9,000 cases per day. India, a little over 5,000. Obviously, population makes a difference. Canada is in a group of among 10 countries at over 1,000 daily cases. Now, this is the global picture of the daily confirmed deaths. Canada, among a group of countries with between 50 and 250 deaths per day. Mexico has jumped above 250. The UK has moved back above 500. Brazil is consistently above 500 deaths per day. And the United States still averaging more than 1,000 deaths per day. And these are some of the countries where the leaders have been criticized for downplaying the coronavirus in the early days.
We can send a coronavirus packing.
Critics say Britain's prime minister failed to take the virus seriously for too long. Then he got the disease. The Russian government was accused of downplaying the disease, and American President Trump suggested the first U.S. case numbers would go down, not up.
Within a couple of days, it's going to be down to close to zero.
Now, the U.S., Russia, and Brazil have the most confirmed cases in the world.
It illustrates that all three countries have failed to have a coordinated nationwide approach to public health restrictions.
Brazil is a brewing formula for catastrophe. Bolsonaro supporters in crowded protests defying the virus amid some of the most densely populated cities in the world. Bolsonaro is seen as Latin America's Donald Trump, and yet Trump is now considering a travel ban on Brazil.
No, Brazil is having some trouble, no question about it.
A stark image, mass grave sites in Brazil. One emergency official says bluntly, we're losing the battle against the virus. Eric Sorensen, Global News, Toronto.
The new series that goes inside the COVID-19 pandemic, from the front lines to the everyday heroes helping us cope with the unprecedented change. Coronavirus, the new reality. A Global News special, Sundays at 7 on Global.